oxidation we have done? Oxidation of this? Okay, write down this one. Oxidation of aldehyde and ketone. Okay, oxidation of aldehyde and ketone. We know aldehyde under oxidation, what it gives? Acid. Aldehyde on oxidation gives acid. On reduction gives alcohol. Right? So there are different oxidizing agent we have. This is you need to memorize actually. There's no reactions we have into this. So for aldehydes under oxidation, it gives acid. The different reagent we use for this reaction is we can use acidified K2Cr2O7, Na2Cr2O7 also we can use, or we can also use KMnO4. Okay, the second one, the three different reagent we use here, that is Stollen's reagent, this three reagent will do. This is the test of aldehyde or ketone, right? So this you have to memorize. Stollen's reagent, Fehling solution test, and Benedict. Okay, these three reagents we'll see. First one, write down Tollens reagent. Write down. Yeah, it is ammonical solution of silver nitrate. Right, Tollens reagent, write down. It is the ammonical solution of silver nitrate it is a mild oxidizing agent, oxidizes aldehyde to carboxylate ion. Mild oxidizing agent, oxidizes aldehydes to carboxylate ions. Write down, when aldehyde is added to it, the silver oxide reduces to metallic silver. The silver oxide reduces to metallic silver, which deposited as a mirror, as a layer actually. Silver like layer, that we call it a silver mirror. Okay, which deposited as a mirror, and this test we also call it as silver mirror test. When aldehyde added to it, the silver oxide reduces to metallic silver, which deposited as a mirror, and we call it as silver mirror test. Okay, reaction I'll write down. Reaction is not important. Say this 2AgNO3 silver nitrate, copy down this reaction, reacts with 2NH4OH and it forms silver oxide Ag2O plus NH4NO3 plus H2. So this Ag2O combines with 4NH4OH and further it gives 2AgNH3 OH plus H2O. This solution is actually Tollens reagent. Okay? Now the reaction of aldehyde, when you add aldehyde into it, RCHO, it reacts with the silver oxide and converts into acid plus silver metal, two molecules of this. Other reaction, we can also write it as RCHO reacts with 2Ag NH3 plus 3OH minus. It gives RCOO minus plus Ag plus 4NH3 plus 2H2. Reaction, like I said, is not important. Carboxylic acid does not form, we'll get ion because the reaction is in basic medium, OH minus is there. So again, we won't get acid, we'll get ions. Okay, the important thing here is write down note. First, you copy down the reaction. Just you keep that in mind that what is Stalin's reagent? It is a silver, it is a ammonical solution of silver nitrate. Okay, that you keep in mind. And we get a silver layer here, silver metal forms, we get a layer of silver, and that's why we also call it a silver mirror test. Okay. One note right on both aromatic and aliphatic aldehyde. Both aromatic and aliphatic aldehyde reduces Stalin's reagent without affecting unsaturation. Reduces Stalin's reagent without affecting unsaturation. Next, second one, failing solution. Write down. It is a mixture of dilute CuSO4 solution with sodium potassium tartrate and NaOH. Sodium potassium tartrate, the formula is not important, but if you want, you can write it down. COONA CHCOOK OH OH. This is sodium potassium tartrate. Not important. Right? So we have solution of CuSO4, dilute CuSO4 with this and NaOH. Okay. When aldehyde added into this solution or failing solution, the cupric ion, I'll write on the reaction, RCHO plus cupric ion is CuO, which is blue in color. Right? Which is blue in color. It oxidizes acid and it forms RCOH plus we'll get Cu2, which is red, or we also write it as brick red. Color changes from blue to red or brick red. Okay, cupric to cuprous. So color change you must keep in mind. Aromatic aldehyde does not give this test. Okay. Next, you write down Benedict solution. Write down. It is a solution of. It's NaOH, no? Yeah. We'll get down. Basically. Acid, you won't get NaOH here. Okay? So write down. Benedict solution. It is a solution of CuSO4, sodium citrate, and sodium carbonate. Aldehyde reduces the solution aldehyde reduces the solution and gives blue colored complex with a precipitate of Cu2O, which is brick red. Okay, this question they have asked, कौन सा precipitate बनता है, right?
CuO.
CuO is blue. Cu2O is brick red. Okay, so this question they have asked, which precipitate we get in this reaction? Okay, so brick red, the color was brick red given. In some books they have given red also. To be more specific, it is brick red color. Okay, so this also you must know. For note you write down, benzaldehyde does not respond to Felling or Benedict test due to alkaline nature of these reagents. Okay. The next we have oxidation of ketones. See, for ketones, we require comparatively stronger oxidizing agent because there is no hydrogen attached to the carbonyl group here, right? To oxidize ketone, we need a stronger oxidizing agent. Right, and the reaction here that we use for the oxidation of ketone, we call it as Bayer-Villiger oxidation reaction. In this reaction, the reagent we use is peroxy acid. For example, CF3CO3H. We can also use CH3CO3H. We can also use carous acid. H2SO5 is carous acid. Okay? Name also you must remember. Carous acid. Okay, we can also use MCPBA. What is MCPBA? Metachlorofurandoic acid. The structure of this is, at meta position, we have chlorine and we have CO3H. This is metachlorofurandoic acid. As you can see, what happened? I didn't see it. This is, we have peroxy linkage into this. Like the CH3, na? Aisa wo structure. CH3, C double bond, O, 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 H. Yes. Peroxy acid we must have. S2SO5 structure kya hai? You know the structure of S2SO5? S double bond O, double bond O. This is the structure of S2SO5. Okay? Yeah. P block, you have also done it redox with KM. Redox with KM, redox with KM, last year. Okay. So, in this reaction, the ketone converts into ester. Okay. So, suppose the reaction is this RC double bond O R dash. When it is heated with CF3CO3H, so product is R C double bond O O R dash. One oxygen you need to insert between one of the alkyl group and carbonyl group. Okay, Which alkyl group? For this we'll see. Okay, like the more electron releasing group, that and carbonyl group. We'll see that what we have to do with this one. Okay. So first of all, the overall reaction is this: the alkyl group which is more electron releasing, that alkyl group and carbonyl group in between that you just put oxygen. Okay, that will be the product here. We get. Okay, mechanism chahiye?
No, sir.
ठीक है मैकेनिज्म कर देते हैं सही लिख देता हूँ दो स्टेप में एच प्लस वहाँ पे जाएगा कार्बन आयन सीओ थ्री माइनस अटैक करेगा ठीक है तो एसिड है सो विल हैव एच प्लस ठीक है दिस एच प्लस विल टेक दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर एंड वी गेट आर सी ओ एच पॉजिटिव एंड आर डैश ठीक है In the next step, what happens? The CF3, C double bond O, OO minus, this behaves as a nucleophile, attacks onto this carbon. Okay? So it forms RC OH R dash OO C double bond O and whatever. CF3, CF3. Okay? Now when you heat this, this bond, because you see this peroxy linkage, this linkage is very weak. Why it is weak? Because of this lone pair repulsion. Right. So slightly you hit this, this bond breaks. Okay. This electron pair is taken up by this oxygen, and this CF3CO- goes out as a leaving group. CF3CO-, which is resonance stabilized also. First of all, CF3 is strong electron withdrawing, and this is also in resonance with this pi bond. Right. So this is stable. And what we get here? Oxygen से electron ले लिया इसने, ठीक है? So oxygen हो गया दुखी, positive charge आ गया इसमें, ठीक है? Now इसको खुश करने के लिए ये बोला चलो मैं आता हूँ तुम्हारे पास, ये इसका electron लेके ये भाग गया उसके पास, ठीक है? So what we get here? ये क्या rearrangement इस पे आ गया positive charge ठीक है now from this since we have H plus initially we have used so this H plus comes out and we get what R C double bond O O R ठीक है understood गॉडर ठीक है तो ये oxygen का दुख देखा नहीं guys ठीक है ये बोला कि चलो वेलकम सो टेक्स दिस बॉन्ड पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड रीअरेंज इटसेल्फ ऑन टू सो ओवरऑल लाइक व्हाट यू हैव टू यू हैव जस्ट इंसर्ट एन ऑक्सीजन राइट बट वेयर यू हैव टू इंसर्ट फॉर दैट यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड राइट सो ऑर्डर यू राइट डाउन लाइक द माइग्रेटरी एप्टीट्यूड ऑफ दिस एल्काइल ग्रुप फॉर दैट यू राइट डाउन द ऑर्डर इट इज इफ इट इज हाइड्रोजन प्रेजेंट मैक्सिमम फॉर हाइड्रोजन देन फिनाइल दिस ऑर्डर वी हैव द माइग्रेटिंग नेचर ऑफ the alkyl group or whatever is attached to this carbonyl group okay both side if it is hydrogen one side maximum tendency of hydrogen we have then we have phenyl then we have 3 degree 2 degree 1 degree this is the order okay electron releasing nature if it is more migrating tendency will be more so if you compare phenyl And then we have chlorophenyl. And then nitrophenyl. Okay, this is the order we have. Okay. Right on, in case of alkyl aryl ketone. In case of alkyl aryl ketone, aryl group migrates, except in the case of tertiary butyl group. alkyl aryl hai, toh aryl will migrate, except we have tertiary butyl groups. So if you have one side tertiary butyl group, another side we have aryl group, then tertiary butyl migrate. Okay. What is the product in this reaction? Which one migrate? This one or this one? CCSH has more tendency, right? So a reaction or product is what? CCSH5
O
C double bond O CS3. In this one, anywhere you put oxygen, we'll get a 6-member ring. Double bond O. In this, which one migrate?
CH3.
Because this is what?
This is more IF.
This is 3 degree, right? And this is 2 degree. So oxygen will be here, and then this CH3 will be here. Here's the product we get. Okay. This is it. Aldehyde and ketone finished. We'll take a break and then we'll see some reactions of carboxylic acid. Okay. Carboxylic acid, we have done most of the reactions. Only few preparation methods we have and 1-2 reactions. That is it. Mostly today also we can finish acid.